Imagine bringing your script to life with just a few clicks. So welcome to this episode of Frame by Frame, where I'll run you through LTX Studio really quick, an awesome tool that will help you create storyboards and transform your scripts into stunning real live action frames from mere prompts. Folks, if you know me, you know how much of a movie buff I actually am. I don't just enjoy watching movies, but also breaking them down and doing a little bit of my own analysis, as you may have guessed from this channel and playlist. Not only that, I also enjoy the craft of filmmaking. I've written a bunch of short films and even directed a couple of them. I'll be honest with you though, there are some things that I like in the entire space of filmmaking, more with respect to pre-production, you know, with scripting, storyboarding and things like that, and then maybe later in post-production with editing in particular. I am not a fan of production one bit, and as much as I can stay away from that, the happier I am. That means though that I have to give the best possible input to the director, the DOP, so that they are able to translate exactly what I have in mind in the screenplay down to the footage, which is why the storyboard becomes super duper critical. All this is on the side, by the way. I'm not even talking about my full-time job at Byju's, where we create insane amounts of content that requires a proper streamlined process, a bunch of storyboarders who then translate that down to post producers and so many people to review content and whatnot. Now imagine if all this could happen in just a few minutes. You know, that entire tedious process, a bunch of folks sitting together, however important it may be, and there are facets of it that we really love and enjoy, which we shouldn't cut. But then there are also all those aspects that can very easily be eliminated just to make things move a little faster. And that's what the power of AI brings to the table. That's where I very recently discovered this tool, LTX Studio. It absolutely blew my mind, and I thought I had to show it to you folks. Right, so running through it really quickly, like I described very briefly, a lot of what you can do in LTX is predominantly on the storyboarding front today. And who knows, I'm pretty certain actually the vision of this company would eventually be to make full-blown movies out over here. But at the moment, the beta version in particular, after I got accepted through the waitlist, just kind of shows you really quickly how you can upload a script. And then from the script, very easily, it is able to extract all the information so clearly. It just identified the two main characters of this screenplay of mine, which, by the way, is a short film that I've been working on. This is a quick deck of the same. I'm going to refrain from talking about the storyline too much. But basically, it's about two brothers, and it's a total existential crisis-esque script. One, really struggling to find the meaning of life, and the other telling him that, you know, it doesn't really matter and you can still continue living and finding meaning in your own life despite not having the entire macros to think about. And I'm going to refrain too much from talking about the story itself, because I want to at the end of the day show you the tool that will enable us to make these storyboards. So as soon as I upload it, as you can see over here, the characters are instantly identified, Shikhar and Shiv. And it even identifies all the different shots. It just breaks the synopsis down. It just breaks it down into the different scenes. And as you can see over here, storyboards are generated very quickly for the scenes. And it's just blowing my mind. I mean, this obviously isn't something that I can straight away use, but it has very clearly identified from the script, as you can see over here, right? Shikhar sitting on the bench, throwing the clock. And that's exactly the shot in the garden with him sitting there in a white kurta. A bunch of frames put together that just takes the entire story forward. And of course, if you know, I actually sit on this for a longer time, if I'm able to tweak the prompts a little bit, I can get exactly the shots that I'm looking for. You can see how I can even play with the camera angles a little bit, you know, just play with the angle here, for example. Shikhar's in a little bit more control, so, you know, the camera from down under in a slight perspective, very similar to the previous shot that gives him the alignment from a framing perspective. But yeah, I mean, the fact that you have this kind of control and then you can see all the shots put together right after, just is just a phenomenal way for you to actually work on a very quick base, a very strong input to some extent if you worked on that base a little bit more to share with somebody who can then take the subsequent stages of your film forward, right? And then look at this. You can also put your voiceover for each character based on the dialogues that you already have in the script. This, for example, works much better as a voice for Shikhar and the kind of stuff he's saying. So it's probably what I'll go ahead with in the final render. And you can also see very clearly, right, how much of content you can actually create on a monthly basis over here on the free plan. Clearly calls out over here up to 3600 seconds per hour of computing cycles available, and I've only used that much, which gives me a lot more computation to work with, to probably even flesh out the entire 18 pager short film if I actually dabble into it. And let's just also check out this particular aspect of it, right? With respect to creating a story from scratch with just a prompt. And there's this other film that I've been working on for the longest time. It's called Silence in the Echo. I got a whole pitch deck in place, which, by the way, at some point I intend to make a video on to just kind of show y'all how to make pitch decks when y'all pitch it to production houses and whatnot. But let's just use the logline of that for now to see how exactly LTX Studio, blows this entire thing into an explicit storyboard for me. Before that though, if you like this real quick exploration and if you want me to do more such breakdowns of crazy AI tools in the creative space, then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And do let me know in the comment section if you've seen this before, if there are some things to keep in mind about it, or if there are other such handy tools that you think will help other people in this space create awesome stuff. So moving on to what exactly LTX Studio is able to offer, right, with the log line. As you can see, with that real quick input, a prominent artist stumbles upon a thriller novel with a plot strikingly similar to her own sordid and criminal past that she thought she had buried, blah, 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 blah. And geez, it is able to identify a bunch of characters that work well for a log line like this. And just reading that particular piece makes me feel a little peaceful, because at the end of the day, that's not what my story is about. So it's good to know that a single log line can, at the end of the day, spark so many different outputs, and mine's still safe to some extent, at the moment at least. But then you can really quickly identify the different styles that you want. I'm looking at, say, something architectural, because the character is a renowned artist, so it needs to have that kind of geometry in the frames and stuff like that. And geez, it's just absolutely blowing my mind, folks. I'm out of words right now. Look at how Ava's character looks. Look at how Victor Blackwood looks. To the extent of curves for one and straight lines for the other, who seems to be a little bit of a dick from AI's perspective in terms of character development, I'm assuming. But wow. And then look at that. It's just broken the entire thing down into different scenes with a storyboard and stuff that needs to happen through each of these shots based on just a single prompt. Right now, of course, this acts as a little bit of a base for me to work with and then develop my own story around it, right? I can actually start tweaking the prompts, getting the storyboard the way I want. And potentially, this is how I ideate and build stories down the line, using a tool like this. And as you can see over here, an establishment shot, a tight shot of the character. And then you can also play with camera angles and stuff like that, right? As you can see over here, taking this shot in particular, and just kind of identifying for myself what exactly the camera motion should be, how long it should last, and geez, it's crazy. It's phenomenal. So yeah, I mean, if this is what the future of storyboarding and script writing and filmmaking is, and at some point if this is how films are going to get created, then I think we are really into something, just mind-blowing, to say the least. So there you have it, a real quick rundown of LTX Studio as a tool, something that I think will be very handy for you, at least from an ideation space today, and who knows what it'll evolve into. But if you like that and if you enjoyed the video, then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Peace out, I'll see you in the next one.